productions that provide first-hand information on the entertainment industry and, of course, celebrity interviews. And because someone, somewhere, somehow has been taking note of this, the show has entered its harvest stage with emerging recognition from the Netherlands that has been in the news for the past couple of days. Its host, USA-based Crystal Beauty, now brandishes the spot of the best online TV presenter. From her Boston abode, young Crystal explains how she got recognized and awarded, plus the meaning of this new status to her TV career. She's one of our main guests, guest at large in this edition of African Cocktail. She will be talking to us from Boston. Don't just go away. She knows her art, and of course, she's been making great inroads in what she does. She is our next guest in this edition of African Cocktail. And exactly 16 minutes past 12, ladies and gentlemen, don't just go away because our main guest will be here with us.
You're sure on the right lane. Adele Clarice fits this description. The USA-based Cameroonian singer enjoys the applause of many of music lovers, including the Crystal Beauty Show. And we're very privileged to have Adele Clarice as our main guest on this edition of the show. Thanks for joining us, dear viewers.
Crystal Beauty, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. How are you?
I'm all right. Thanks. And you?
Good.
So, how is Boston today?
It's raining. I don't like the rain at all.
Okay, you just listened there to cuts of the Crystal Beauty Show. And it's, of course, that very beautiful and captivating show that has been brought to the stage. It's been brought to the center stage, of course. And like I said in my intro earlier on in this edition of African Cocktail, the show and its presenter are now harvesting the fruits of their labor. Crystal, you recently got a recognition and was named the best online TV presenter by a Netherlands-based organization. Could you just tell us which organization was this and what exactly took place?
The organization is called AFTV. It's an African television.
Right. And recently, they named you the best TV show presenter. So, could you just describe the reaction you had as soon as this news was brought to you? What kind of feelings were in you at that moment?
Oh my goodness, I actually didn't believe it was me. I thought they actually got the wrong number, because what happened was I woke up at 5 a.m. and I saw a voicemail on my phone. The voicemail, and he said, you know, we'd like to talk to you. Please call us back. You know, it's very important. And when I called back, the man on the other line was like, is it possible for you to come to the Netherlands in April? And this actually happened in, I think, January. And I was like, what for? And he goes, because we're giving you an award for the best TV presenter. And I screamed, and, you know, I was like, are you sure it's me? You know, he said, are you a Crystal Beauty Show? And I'm like, yeah. And he goes, yeah, it's for you. And, yeah, it was very exciting, and I actually couldn't believe it. It took me a while to sink it in. It's not until they actually sent me an email confirming, you know, the award and sending me the picture of, you know, my name on it and everything. I was like, oh, it actually happened.
when you say you couldn't believe Crystal Beauty, does it mean that you don't have confidence in what you do?
No, not at all. It's just, I didn't believe that I would be recognized in a place like that because what I do is I usually follow, I tend to keep track of my followers, okay?
Right.
And I keep track of the location where most of my viewers come from. And Netherlands is not even on the top 10, you know? And so it was just a shock that people there are watching my show and they actually recognize me for my work.
So, what do you think would have attracted those who recognize you about the Crystal Beauty Show? When you watch that show, when you sit back and watch it, right, what do you think can attract somebody to it?
Well, actually, the CEO of AFTV told me that what got his attention was the fact that I was very consistent, and he could see that I was, you know, working very hard.
Right. And that kind of fetched you the awards which you have today. Okay, but what does this award mean to you? Does it spur you to even work harder rather than just lie on your laurels and say, well, I'm up there, people are recognizing me, I'm having awards? What does it mean to you?
It means everything to me. It actually makes me want to work harder. You know, because it made me realize that actually that there's people out there watching me that I'm not even aware of, you know. So I'm aware of some of the people that watch me, but then I have to be conscious that there's other people that might not reach out to me, you know, or might not even comment on something, but they're watching me. So it makes me want to improve and impress them more.
So to whom are you dedicating this special honors?
Everybody, actually, because getting to this point wasn't something that I could do on my own. You know, I have to thank all the people who watch the show, the people who talk about it, the people who share it, and obviously, you know, my close friends who have been like my cheerleaders. You know, I have moments where I get so frustrated and I'm like, I can't do this, and I have people who are like, no, Crystal, you've been doing it for this long, you can do it, you know, and so basically everybody, you know, especially the fans, those people that, you know, watch it and hear, yeah.
Now, there are some people who are listening to us and maybe getting you talk about this show for the very first time. They might not have been lucky to come across it. Could you just describe what the Crystal Beauty Show is to these listeners, and how can it be viewed, when, and some other thing you think is important to know about the show?
Yeah, the Crystal Beauty Show actually aims to promote talent. You know, it doesn't, it's very diverse in the sense that we promote musicians, you know, actors, entertainers. You know, I've even had pastors on my show. So it's for everybody. The slogan for the show is "Your Voice, Your Show." So it's for everybody. And, you know, what if you want to promote something, you can come on the show. If you want to talk about your talents or something, business or, you know, an organization, whatever it is, we, you know, the show is open to everybody. And to view the show, actually, you can see the show on a couple of websites. It's currently being shown on 9flix.com, which is a Nigerian online TV.
Right.
It's being shown on GTV.com, which is a Cameroonian online TV. And of course, it's being shown on the CrystalBeautyShow.com. And also, you can just go to YouTube and type in CrystalBeautyShow to, you know, view and subscribe.
Now, incidentally, the next guest on your show will be P Brothers, whom we are having as main guest in this edition of African Caucus. So when is that show coming up, and what was your experience talking to these two great boys?
The show will be out on the 30th. I think that's in 7 days. Yeah. And it was an honor to have them on the show. I actually had fun. They are very down to earth. They were very flexible because the condition in which we had the show was not so convenient, you know, but they were very understanding and they were very flexible and, you know, they're very friendly and we had fun on set. We definitely did. Yeah.
Crystal Beauty, thank you so much for stopping by to tell us about this latest in the world of the Crystal Beauty Show. Accept our congratulations and we hope that you're going to put in more effort to make the Crystal Beauty Show the best, and we actually lot this initiative and the great effort you are putting in. Thank you so much, and do have a fantastic rest of the day out there in Boston.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Crystal Beauty is her name. She's a young Cameroonian who has delved into online TV, and she's doing it so well. Okay, African Cocktail is coming to you from Africa Radio with NS Kanjo and Flexi and Dexter of the P Brothers Band as main guests in this edition. Let's go music, then we'll go back to Maryland and meet our main guest.